Have you heard about space weather? It is a field that might still be unknown to many people, but it is something that we should all be aware of and take seriously. While space weather is invisible to the naked eye, it can have severe consequences to us here on Earth, our communications and technology networks, even to the point of placing our lives at risk. Despite being 150 million kilometers away from Earth, the Sun can suddenly eject particles and plasma from its surface, known as solar flares or coronal mass ejections. And when these physical, electrically charged expulsions collide with the Earth's magnetic environment, it can do extensive damage.
The importance of monitoring space weather is it really relates to the fact that as a modern society, we've become very dependent on electronic devices and electronic communications. And space weather involves a lot of high energy moving charges, which results in very large currents, which affects the magnetic field. And these disturbances can affect electronic devices, such as communications or navigation.
So too for our security and weather prediction systems. The interconnectedness and interdependence of all these systems means that their performance and reliability can be severely impacted in the event of an interruption or failure. Solar storms can cause significant satellite disruption, potentially knocking out our communication and navigation mechanisms. Just think of the disastrous impact that would have on the global aviation industry. Space weather can produce electrical surges in power lines, leading to widespread blackouts, and can even have an impact on long-distance oil and gas pipelines.
One of the sort of lesser known impacts from space weather is additional radiation exposure to passengers and crew in flights, particularly flights that fly at the higher latitudes.
The prediction of impending space weather events and their impacts is an essential tool in preventing these severe effects on vulnerable infrastructure and the economy.
Space weather has become a global phenomenon, and in many of the first world countries like the US, the UK, space weather has become a national risk to them. And they've made this part of their national risk register.
There is a network of solar observation hubs around the world which constantly monitor the sun and forecast the likelihood and impact of solar storms. The International Civil Aviation Organization has recognized the importance of these storms on flight safety and has therefore recommended that space weather information be filed as part of normal flight plans in the near future. The South African National Space Agency, or SANSA, has been developing space weather services over the past decade and, based on their research and resulting expertise, recently underwent an extensive assessment process to earn the designation of becoming a regional space weather information provider, one of only 5 centres in the world to receive a designation.
It now will be responsible for providing all space weather information to the aviation sector, not only in South Africa, but also into Africa.
Currently, SANSA has the ability to indicate the space weather impact on high-frequency communications. In the future, 3 other impact areas will be added: that of the impact on navigation applications, satellite communications, and radiation exposure.
So we have designed a state-of-the-art 24/7 operational space weather center.
SANSA's space weather infrastructure and capability will be upgraded at a cost of 90 million rand with a funding injection from the Department of Science and Innovation over 3 years with an expected completion date in 2022.
It will be 788 square meters situated on the property here in Amanas. It will have a fully equipped control room that will monitor, forecast and predict space weather around the clock. It will also have the capacity to accommodate a new research chair in solar physics, which will up our knowledge generation and our capability in terms of interpretation and expertise. And it will also have a 100-seater auditorium, because one of our plans around space weather is to create awareness, to run information sessions, to have public lectures, to take this information and share it.
In addition, communication links to remote monitoring stations will be upgraded to ensure real-time data transfer and the capability to predict and forecast space weather impacts enhanced. SANSA is working closely with the South African Weather Service and Air Traffic Navigation Services to implement the space weather flight plan requirements, but there are also potential uses for the data in other national sectors. SANSA will ultimately provide information, warnings, and alerts to the defense, maritime and energy sectors in South Africa, protecting our nation's operational integrity.
We are the designated space weather forecasting and warning center for Africa. All aircraft flying over the African sector will rely on space weather services and forecasts that we generate here for planning and for actual in-flight purposes.
International stakeholders include other space weather centers, international research partners, and global space agencies such as NASA and the European Space Agency. These stakeholders will assist SANSA in developing the skills required for the provision of regional and international space weather information, and also help build SANSA's capabilities in space weather operations and research. This exciting new Space Weather Center will enhance SANSA's and therefore South Africa's position in international space science research, as well as driving the growth of solar physics in the country while protecting us and our technology from the consequences of solar storms.